Hi, welcome back. In the last video section, we have learned how to model this kitchen design. In this session, we are going to learn how to apply the textures and how to get them realistic in landscape, and how to create lights, applying sample lights and IES lights. And finally, I will show you a sample rendering setup in landscape and get this realistic view. This is our target, and let's move on. See, in this model I have created these panels and this island section, and also I have showed you how to get these blocks, how to get them and how to copy in the scene, and how to create these kind of proxies. Actually, I have got some proxy models. Why? Because these blocks are having lot of higher memories, so which are not suitable for a sample scene. So now it's time to apply some textures to this model. My target is to get this dark kind of theme. So for that, I will choose some sample materials which are available free or online. I already showed you how to get those materials. Now it's time for us to create those materials. So in the SketchUp, we can create materials using this create material. At the material section, it will be available. After clicking create material, it will show in the previous material selected. For that, just click on this empty material, deform material, and click create new material. Here you can create the name. I will create as a kitchen top, and select here texture and guide to folder where you have saved your textures. I'm using dark wood materials. Yeah, I'm going to apply this one. Check the color and click open and click OK. Later on we can set this dimension. Just click OK. This is for top, on top of the panels. Like, I want to apply it for all the cupboard doors here. And I will create one more material for back structures. Click open and click OK. Like, I have created two different materials, and for the design purpose I want to use a light color. Click again, create new material for new structure. Yeah, I want to go with this. And click open. Now I have created three different materials. Let's try to apply it. You can find your textures over here. These three, I have created three different materials. First of all, I will choose this one. Okay, after selecting this material, directly click on the door itself. Automatically it will apply to the entire one. Actually, I have done these all are components. So what I'm going to do, I will just double click it and I will select this face. Automatically other also selected. Just apply to one door, automatically it will apply to entire components. Maybe these are different components, I guess. So again, double click, select this B for shortcut, and apply. So maybe these are all different. So double click and apply to it. So try to apply on all the required doors. For the back of the panels, I have choose this one. Simply I will click on this model. Automatically it will apply to the all the faces. Why? Because it's a block. And this one too. I don't want on this landing. I want a stone. I want a marble on this top pad. So for that, I will create one more material, like say marble. Like, I will use Cade. Try to name the textures as you can place them as an order. This texture, I want to use this one. Click open and click OK. Simply double click it, select this face, apply. Now it is applied on the top. Click outside to get it out. simply I want to apply the same material here as well, and I want to apply I'm using this pick tool sample paint. Already in the model I have applied this material. Either you can choose from here or you can choose from here, and I will click on this model. Already on this face one material is applied, so rest of the model will be applied here. And I want to use one more material, different material, light color, this one. You can double click it, select the face B and click apply. Same here on these two faces I want light color, just for design purpose. Later on we can adjust the scale. Just now let it be, and I want aluminium. Just I will create aluminium. Spelling is very much important. Why? Because in the Enscape it will detect, depends on the material. I will just use a dark color, somewhere like this, and click OK and apply on this model. I want to apply on this frame as well, and that too, these frames. Select this B, and I want to use a glass. Simply you can choose from the glass section. I want to use this one, translucent gray. Double click the component, select the face of required, and apply the material automatically. It's a component, so it will apply to the other parts as well. And for these lights I want to create a kind of a goldish thing. For that I will use material like metal, metal gold. Why I'm using this in the Enscape, while we starting Enscape you can find out easily. Light color I'm using it, and double click, select this part, we will apply this material to it. And in the glass we have this one translucent. Actually I have used a block, already modeled block here, so which comes with the predefined materials, so we can tweak them in the Enscape. And in the curtains I want to create a fabric material, RIC fabric, use textures, and the this one, click OK and apply. Control Z, it is applied to the frame also. Simply double click, select the frame, choose from the material outside and click here. Now it is different. Yeah, now it's good. I want lighter cream color curtain, so just pick this texture and edit. Try to use other colors. If you select the overlay colors, so actually fabric texture is also applied here, but the color is only altering. And I try to use opacity 96%. That's good. Like I said, translucent see-through type. Now it's okay. And I want to apply same metal to this part. Since see, actually I want this chair in this texture, so I will use sample this one, double click, select the music, the apply. Automatically it will have the same material. We didn't need to bother much about the UVs here. Why? Because we don't focus on here. We will take a full size picture. So on an average I'm applying materials, and all these materials already comes with predefined. One more thing, switchboards. I will create will use switch and try to do little bit dark color. Simply click on them. These all are blocks, so automatically internal objects will also apply with the same material. I think we have applied everything, and now it's time to create floor materials. Click here, floor. Double click, select this. in this way you can apply all the required materials to the models. Later on we can go with fixing the scale. Now it's time for us to make this cladding here. I want to use a panel type of cladding, a wooden type. I want to use this same dark texture only, but I want to make as a panel. So for that I will make a panel here. Double click, I will select only these faces up to here. From here on here I want to make the panel. So I will use Ctrl C to copy, and the outside file for edit, paste in place. Automatically those faces will be copied, and I will move it out and try to model it. This is my workflow from the first video onwards. Repeat. So I will select here MC 0.5 inch, and select this MC outside, like place it here, divided by 25. This is my paneling, and same I will do this in this direction also. Just filled up with this, not a problem, we can clean it. So this is the end, so we need to erase here. Triple click, delete. Same way, erase E, this part. Now select all these faces and choose delete. Now select a panel. Now I am going to teach you one more plugin I used as for your selecting tools. What I want to do, I want to use a panel type of extrusion. So I will use a joint push pull command, but I want to select all these inner faces. That's a two time taken one. I will triple click it and make it a groove, and inside that group I will select this face, and I will use this one, select the same area. If you click here, automatically same area will be selected. Hold Ctrl and use, select the same area. See, automatically entire will be selected except these internals. We don't need this. This will be under the sink, and I will use joint push pull. Click and drag. Automatically it will apply to the every face. Send it back. Offset distance 0.5 inches. See the paneling. Click it out. Now we have the panels. Now move it back. M. 25 feet. If you click on scene, automatically it will go inside, and try to apply with the same material. See what happening here, it is a flickering glitch we are getting. Why? Because the two faces are at the same place. I will use the hide, double click it, select these two faces and delete it, and click it out. Now see, no flickering or switchboards are inside the plan. Now we will get the same color. Now select the switchboards, move it out M on the green axis, same on the green axis, choose on this space here also, same. This way I have modeled everything. Now we need to adjust the scale first. So first of all, one by one, choose this pick tool, choose the material, go to edit, choose 3 feet. At 3 feet the pattern is visible, will like quite good, and on the back also same to same. And the flooring, select this floor, edit. 10 looks fine. So now we have completed all the texturing part. After finishing the modeling, it's time for us to open Enscape. Just start Enscape using the start button. If you click it here, automatically Enscape will be open. If you open Enscape, first it will open like this. You can use these navigate commands just like a gaming, WASD EQ, like forward, backward, left, right. You can fly through here. See, wings means fly mode is activated, and EQ, both are for up and down, both are those. If you hold on shift, it will move faster, and control also same. And fly, see, between walk and fly use space command. Now I can just go through the buildings. If I switch between walk mode, I mean fly mode to walk mode, if I click on space, automatically this view adjusted to normal human height, and it can't pass through the walls. You can't go through the walls, right? Just like a normal person walking around the world. Like that, you can go here, and you can use a mini map, and we can use a video editor. I can show you how to edit videos in later on videos using left mouse button panning. In the right mouse button, you can use a rotate and hold shift and mouse middle click for dragging the screen. So it's enough. Try to remember all these small shortcuts. I will just hide this by using H shortcut key, and we can have much space to work with. So if you view like this, compared to the model, like these are proxies, but in the Enscape you can see the real picture. And here also I have used some decorative pieces. You can download them from 3dwarehouse.com. By viewing this, I don't like it much. Why? Because some, these are like sharp looking, and automatically glass parts will be like a translucent gray, and it will get a default reflection kind of thing. Why? Because these materials applied with the name glass on it. See, if you select this one, the name is translucent glass. This is the key which is useful in Enscape software to identify the material, type of material. And also you can observe this is resembling the aluminium, right? Why? Because I have used the material key name as aluminium. See, aluminium. Automatically it will detect and apply the material properties of metal. And here also it is applied with some metal properties. Why? Because I have applied with metal gold name. To choose this one, see, metal gold, I have used the name as metal. If I remove this one, backspace, click enter, it won't get that metallic effect. If I add the name METAL, metal, enter, it's a metallic property. Now you got the clear picture, I guess. Now it's time for us to apply materials. See, now I'm going to teach you how to adjust the material properties in a Enscape which look cool, realistic effect. See, first start with this one. I'm going to do like I will place this window, and I will try to decrease the SketchUp a little bit so that we can work simultaneously at a time. Pick the material, and at the Enscape, like, you will get two different windows for starting and other settings, and this is for rendering. Capturing means rendering the images and rendering the videos. Now this is the one for creating Enscape materials. If you click it here, automatically it will open material palette. Whatever the materials we have applied in the scene, those will be shown here. And the selected one here, and it is saying albedo means that is a diffuse one. And type here, you can see grass type, water type, fire type. We can keep it the default one. Don't need to go through all. What I want to do is I just use some shining, like a polished type of wood material. For that I need to click on roughness. It is like 90. we need around like 20 or something. Just click here. See, if you hover over any kind of bars, just right side of this one, we are getting some more option button. At the roughness, click here, set a value, use 20. Right away, it is showing that it's like a shiny one. Not sufficient, I want to use a little bit more. Either you can drag it here, or you can set a value. 10 over 10. See, fine glossy. Or you can use some kind of 15 or something. Depends upon your taste and all, you can adjust here. If it is a metal, 100%. If it is non-metal, it is at 0. Like metal type of materials, you need to drag across here. If not, keep it here. Specular for reflection properties, you can vary that specular effect here. And for the bump, normal maps, you can use this. Either you can use you can upload the normal map here, or you can use the albedo, like means with respect to diffuse itself, you can create this one. I am for this material, I don't want to use this bump mapping, and also this one too. I can use this for floor. I will show you that time. Now what I need to do, I need to pick this and try to adjust this one. Roughness same, set a value 15, a glossy one. And self illumination for lights, I will show you later. Pick this material, it's already at 20. Why? Because we need to check with the name marble. By default, it is shown the ceramic properties. I want a little bit more glossy, so I will use 10. Okay. A similar way, you can adjust all the required materials and all. Now it's time for us to make this floor a little bit more realistic. It's like a value like 20, and the shininess increased, right? Now I want to use this bump mapping. You can simply add the normal map here. I will use this normal map. Not much of change, but if you can zoom it further little, you can observe that bump pattern. If you apply a normal map, only the image itself controlling the that bump pattern. If you change it to bump map, you can vary the, but the bump is off. Why? Because we need to set a value -3. Or you can do one more thing, you can simply delete it and use the albedo 0.25. yeah, for this value it's like a good looking. Either use a normal map, or you can use the albedo. You can apply directly in Enscape. Finally, we have adjusted all the materials as you required, but one problem is the lights are not realistic, and I want to add some more lights. In the material itself, you can change the properties, like we need to choose it there, like just at the right beside of the name. See, now it is normal piece of paper like looking. If you rename it to emissive, emissive, click enter, right away it will look like a light, right? Emissive is a keyword for light materials. Now you can create a number of light portions, whatever you need. I will create one normal strip lights here, and I will show you here at the bottom of this one. I will create a rectangle. I just create a normal rectangle box here. I will create duplicate it. I will create new material, this one, okay, and I will apply this light 2 material over here. Just try to observe here, it's not like acting like light, because there is no emissive material applied on here. If I use EMISSIE, now it's look like a light. Right, it's looking like a light, but it's not producing any light here. To produce a light, we need to create light objects at the Enscape section. These are this folder is to create objects. Here you can already showed you how to create a proxies here. Right, we said we can create like a sphere, spot, line and different type of lights. Now I'm going to create light type line. So to create light, you need to click two times. First click for placing it and second for location and all. Right away it is created, showing like a strip one. In the SketchUp itself, you can move the object as you are moving a normal components. Using the move tool, I want to rotate it. With this luminosity, you can try to observe at the both locations at the same time. If I increase the luminosity, it will go brighter. If you decrease it, you can little bit less. And if you increase the length, observe clearly. Here also, you can observe it. If we are just increasing the length, by observing here, you can choose how much length of line you want. This way we can create strip lights, but I want to go a little bit more classy, so for that I am going to use IES lights. So for that I don't need this this light and this one too. I want to create normal circular lights. For that I will use a circle command. I want to use this spotlight. To create spotlight, we need click four clicks. First point for centering the light, and second point for facing, and third point for target. Like in Z direction, I want to create first point. I mean, and the second also target. So with total four clicks, we have created this light. You can rotate it. I have created like 6 different lights. Not much looking as a lights. We need to change the background, like lighting is like afternoon. To observe the lights more clearly, you need to adjust the time. You can use by using in the SketchUp itself, you can change the sun settings, or simply hold the Inkscape, hold shift and drag it. Drag the mouse. You can increase or decrease the time. You can observe at this corner. Like I will use around 9 a.m. Morning 9 a.m. lighting would be like much cooler in landscape. You can see this reflection, but lighting not much intensive, right? While selecting the object, if you select the light, automatically that property will appear here. And I will change the luminosity. See, now you can observe here, and you can change the beam angle like this, or you can use the IES file. I will use the IES file to change it. You can download this IES file or at online for free. See, at the right beside you can see the preview. I want to use this one, this light, for the decoration purpose display. You need to put this IES light. So I will select this one. This is the display. Click open. Right away in the properties also it will change the look. And here also you can observe. I will increase the intensity. Depends on your taste, you can increase or decrease the intensity. See, here also you can the decorative pieces, you will get the like bloom effect. If you don't like the properties of the model, like if you want to change this color, actually I don't like this. If you want to change this color, you can't change it here. You need to open the source file, and if you change it over there, automatically it will change over here. So now I believe we have created all required things. I guess we have created the panels and the texture also we have changed it and also everything. I guess we have finished the every model. Try to keep small window of Enscape. Why? Because it will affect the graphic of your PC. It will depends on your the graphic card and all. By the way, it's looking good. I guess now we need to set up the basic rendering settings. Before going to this, see, we have in the Enscape you can add the proxies assets from online, or you can change the materials and you can add sounds. Now we need to use the settings. This one for general settings, we don't need this one, we need this one, visual settings. At the visual settings, see, first one is the rendering image atmosphere capture. At the rendering, we need to choose outlines. Do you need any outlines or not? I don't want outlines. If you choose outlines, it's like a black color things are appears. I don't like it. And what kind of mode you want, choose it none. The default would be nice. If you choose auto exposure, automatically the brightness of the atmosphere will be adjusted. If you deselect it, automatically it will be dark, and you need to adjust with this bar. Or simply you can choose auto exposure. Why? Because in Enscape auto exposure option is quite good. That's why I'm using this one. And projection also you choose 2 point. If you choose perspective, the lines here you can observe, it will be like a tilted, depends on camera, it will adjust the angle. I don't want that. Always you choose 2 point perspective. No matter you choose, it will try to adjust as vertical as possible. Next one, autofocus for depth of field, for bokeh effect. And you can choose, I will show you that in later videos. And render quality, always choose ultra. And in image, you can adjust the contrast settings and all the motion and bloom also. If you observe here, if I increase the bloom, see the bloom effect. If you double click here, automatically it will go back to default value. In anywhere, if you double click on the bar, automatically it will go back to the default settings. And atmosphere also, you can go with the fog intensity, like background, sky illumination and all. Actually for interior, we don't need to bother much of it. But we can choose this one, horizon. If you use, try to observe here. If you use forest, a forest will be, background, forest background will be selected, but I like urban, that's why I'm keeping it. You can choose rotate, you can adjust the background image. And at the capture, we need to select the resolution for Full HD. You can create Ultra HD with easy, without any problem. Within 30 seconds, you can produce the ultra quality image in Enscape. But for sample, I'm using Full HD. And you can choose custom also. You can adjust your desired values, but beyond the limit, like ultra is the maximum one. If you go beyond limit, automatically it will crash. I don't suggest you that one. But ultra is a good one. And use viewport aspect ratio is whatever the window we are placing in the SketchUp, automatically it will take, but I don't need that. Try to use this show safe frame while rendering. I will show you that. And image also, what kind of depth range and all, everything you can IDs you can keep it here. And file format, obviously I will choose PNG lossless file. And in the video we can show this one panorama and all. I can show you that in separate videos. Right now everything is set up. Up to now is everything fine. Now it's time for us to go rendering. Try to adjust the camera as you like, from where you want to capture the image. And if you click on here, render image, automatically it will open a next pop-up window. See, here we have a feature like whatever the scenes we have created, automatically those scenes will be rendered. But I want this one, so I'm not choosing here. Try to click on render. If you select the save frame, the capture mode, if you check, I mean, if you select the checkbox save frame, if you click on render, automatically it will show you a black frame from where to where aspect ratio will be rendered. Automatically it will show you. I mean, later on you can see, don't click on OK. Later on you can try to adjust the camera, from where to where you want to render. I will just try to capture this one, and if you click OK, after adjusting this, if you click OK, automatically it will ask to where to save the file. I will choose desktop, automatically renames, and if you click save, automatically it will start the rendering.